Yeah.
Yeah, they had body healer and right in her and then the house where you lived there.
Did they?
Yeah. Yeah. Instead of having it in the church or in the Westlaw funeral home, it was right in the house in those days they lived.
Yeah.
And the prayers and body healing right in the house, yeah. I remember Dad clipping them, getting the scissors and clipping a piece of Alphonse's hair to save the souvenir. Memento, more or less, more than a souvenir.
Yeah, memento, yeah.
But how old was it? Can you tell?
Yeah, we can look at the chart there, obviously, and figure it out. But you were a young guy.
Yeah.
But old enough to understand what a lousy day that was, I guess.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can remember he'd been being sick for a long time. He was casting away for a long, long time. I think he lost one.
When Alphonse died, I was 10 years old. So. He died in 49, so I remember him a little more.
Today is Sunday, June 20th, 2003. My name is Catherine Allarie Chevalier, and we're here with Maurice and Henrietta in their home in Jarvie, where they have lived for 53 years. Today, we are going to ask them a few questions about their past and discuss some of their history and make a record of it, and I hope we're going to have a lot of fun doing it. Henrietta, let's start with you. What is your full name, and did you have any nicknames?
Henrietta Balva Allarie. After I got to Jarvie, a lot of people called me Chris because of my last name.
What was your last name?
Christofiak.
Okay.
And my name wasn't Henrietta when I was in Poland. When I started school in Heisler, they didn't like my Polish name.
Which was?
Which was Henrika.
Ah.
So they thought maybe Henrika was Henrietta. So then I've been Henrietta ever since.
Well, I had a nickname, Mo. It wasn't used extensively. But anyway, my full name is Maurice Omer Allarie. And when we were going over to Poland in 1985 on a trip to get my passport, and they couldn't find my name. All they could find was Joseph Morris, and he was born in 27. But he also was born on the 27th of June, and I thought my birthday was the 26th. And up until then, I'd always celebrated my birthday on the 26th of June. So now I have two birthdays, 26th, 27th. I figured I was the right guy. My name was Joseph Morris Allarie. Not Morris Omer Allarie. So I had all my credentials. I'd always been Morris Omer. So I changed my name from Joseph Morris to Morris Omer. So now I am Morris Omer.
And where was it?
My first home was behind the store. It was a three-room house. No, four rooms. Kitchen and three bedrooms. Or a living room and kitchen combined and three bedrooms. Well, we had a cook stove, and it was wood. We had a chop wood, I remember that. And then our heater was a big heater right beside it, and we threw logs into it for heat. And it was about, you could take a log, maybe about 30 inches, maybe 36 inches long, and shove it in this heater. And that's mostly what we had all the time until we got modern, and then eventually we went to an oil heater over time. We had running water too. You'd grab a pail of water and run to the well. And then our bathroom was outside. It was only a single holder though. But they didn't have any toilet paper in a convent in Morinville. It was just the old magazines, Eaton's catalog and stuff like that. It was all cut up in little squares. And it was very slippery. The only time we had toilet paper was when the Japanese oranges came at Christmas time, and then we used to save all the paper. Now, that was pretty good, to eat the oranges.
What kind of house was it?
My first home was in Poland, and it wasn't a very big house, but it was it had hardwood floors, and that's all I can remember, that I know it had the hardwood floors.
How long did you live there?
Until I came to Canada, and I was 4 and a half.
Oh, so you wouldn't have remembered a lot. When you came to Canada, where did you move to first?
To Heisler.
Straight to Heisler.
Mm-hmm.
And how long did you live there?
Till I left home for about 18 years.
It was really quite an accomplishment for you in those days to go to secondary education. What made you choose the career that you chose, and what was that career?
When I was still in high school, my teacher, he knew I was going to try to go to university or do something, but my father couldn't afford to send me, and I wanted to be a nurse. And my father said no. He said, you can't be a nurse because I'm worried about you. I'll be worried about you then because you pick up something in the hospital. So he said, but you can be a teacher. And the high school teacher, I told him this story, and he says, well, I think you're better off. Just go and be a teacher, because in about 7 or 8 months you can be working. And he didn't know about the nursing part of it.
Did Did you enjoy your teaching career?
Yes, I did.
Oh, how many years did you actually teach?
23 years.
I was a boarder. I boarded out in a private home for 2 years.
And that would have taken you to the end of high school?
Grade 12, yeah.
And did you continue on in any other secondary education after that?
Yeah, when I came to Jarvie, I married a teacher. No, I was home for a few years, maybe a year.
What do you remember about the character and personality of your parents? And let's start with your mom.
Mom was always very kind and generous. But I don't remember too much about her.
How old were you when she died?
11.
11, so the same age as you were when your mom died, Henrietta.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
And your dad? You remember more about
him? Well, Dad lived here with us, so. Yeah, I remember him well, and he was never severe, always generous, worked hard, and you can see him working in his books, 1 or 2 in the morning, and he's back in the store before we ever got up. So he did work real hard. He had a hard time to get us people there sometimes. When we were home on holidays, he had a hard time waking us up in the morning. But he was very patient, never swore. Just come back and tell you, hurry up, guys, need some help. And he never took anything for himself, Dad. Yeah. He went on a holiday once, we hope we can, yeah.
Yeah. And Henrietta, you probably didn't know Morris's mom.
No, I didn't.
But you remember his dad. What do you remember about his dad?
I just remember that he was a workaholic. he just worked so many hours a day, I don't know how he managed.
And you said that he lived in your home here.
Mm-hmm.
And you had children of your own. How did that work out?
It was a busy time for me because the boys were still here.
The brothers?
Oh, yes. Yeah. There was Louis and Paul and Elsa and Teddy and Roger and Armand and...
My goodness, you married into a pile.
And so they were all at home, and Shirai's and Alcid, oh, they were all here.
Now, when we say here, was that this house or was this still?
This house.
Mm-hmm. So when got married, the family, were they already here or did they move in after?
They were already here when I came. Mr. Allarie loved wrestling, and he would come home to watch it with Father St. Arnold, and who else was there here? Well, some of the priests, they would come down here and watch wrestling with Mr. Allarie.
That's the only time I've ever seen Dad get excited.
Yes, he just loved it.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, do you want to know how long one trip took?
Yes.
Well, it was... in the 40s, it was in the summertime, so we decided, Alphonse and I decided we would like to go to Edmonton with Dad, so we coaxed him and he let us go. And we got into Edmonton, and we couldn't go into any theaters or any public places because they were all closed to kids because of the
polio.
Polio.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we left Edmonton, we spent the day in business, Dad had business there, we spent the day there. And we got back to Westlock and it was raining. So Dad took us in and we all went into the cafe to have a bite to eat before we continued home. Because he knew what the road would be like. I think it was about 7:30 when we left Westlock. And we got home at noon the next day, or 11 o'clock. They were just getting out of church. But we drove to as far as Scanlon School, which is about 8 miles from Jarvie, and then Dad had to park in the schoolyard, and then we walked from there, so
How did you meet?
Maurice came down to the tea trees in November after it had snowed quite a bit. And
here in Jarvie?
In Jarvie. Mm-hmm. And he and Bill Evans came down and wanted us to go tobogganing. So that's how we met.
When you say us, who else was there?
Mary Sheridan and I were in the tea trees.
Oh.
We came in September. We were supposed to teach in DAP originally. And we came by train with two suitcases and with our clothes, and that's all we brought. And we knew the teacher was, the teacher each was furnished, you know, we didn't have to bring anything else. And we were on the train with Mrs. Vigneault and Germaine coming down, and we got real friendly and had a good time laughing and everything. And we got to DAP, and Mr. Renwick was the teacher from Jarvie. He stopped us as we were coming off and said to go back on because we were teaching in Jarvie. That's all the notice we had.
Oh my goodness.
And so then we got back on and we surprised Mrs. Vigneault and Germaine and said we are coming to Jarvie because they were saying we wish you would come to Jarvie instead.
Well, that was preordained, eh?
Mm-hmm. Right. It wouldn't happen today.
Can you tell us a little bit about your wedding ceremony? Was it a big wedding?
Not too big. It was mostly relatives from my side and Morris's side, and it was in Heisler.
It was a nice wedding.
Nice day?
Nice day.
It had snowed the night before.
Frost.
And it was
nice snow.
Yeah, and then the sunshine in the morning, and it warmed up, but it
was a beautiful day.
Yes, it was a nice day.
Well, what was the most rewarding thing about being a parent?
The most rewarding thing, I think, is after they've grown up and had the grandchildren, I think that we get lots of pleasure out of that. We spend a lot of time with them, and having grandchildren, I guess, is the most rewarding thing.
Well, we're just about finished here. Do you have, after your long life of good blessings, one thing that you would like to share with the next generation to help them be as successful as you've been?
Enjoy each day because it flies back by so quickly.
That's good.
I think I would go along with that too. I think that time goes by quickly. It doesn't look like I've been here for 75 years.
Yeah.
And when I think of Mom, she was 39.
Sad thing. She missed out on a lot.
Isn't that strange? Because my mother was also 39.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. We really enjoyed this.
Thank you.
see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. Much more than I never knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful.
Today is Tuesday, June 24th, 2003. My name is Catherine Allarie Chevalier, and we're here this evening with Arthur and Pauline at their home in Edmonton, where they have lived for 20 years. Pauline, we'll start with you tonight, and we'd like to know, what was your full name, including any nicknames that you may have had?
My full name is Pauline Teresa Cowette Allarie. I didn't have any nicknames. Nope.
Were you named after someone special?
I was named after my grandma Montpellier. Her name was Pauline. Yeah.
And where were you born?
I was born here in Edmonton on August the 15th, 1932 at the Royal Alec Hospital.
And where was your first home?
In Morinville.
And what kind of house did you live in?
We lived on a farm. 2 miles east and 1 mile north of Morinville. We lived there till I was 7 years old, and then we moved to Jarvie.
And did you stay the rest of your life in Jarvie before you got married?
We stayed the rest of our life in Jarvie till we got married and moved to Fawcett.
How many children were in your home?
I have a sister and an aunt and a brother, Bobby. There was just the three of us.
Three of you.
Yeah, just a small family.
Ah. Who were your parents? What were their names and maiden name?
My mom was Clara Maupelli, and my dad was Hilaire Couette.
And where were they born?
My mother was born in St. Albert, and my dad was born in Saint-Libert, Quebec.
And how did they meet, being that far apart?
Well, my dad and their family came to Morinville, in 1907. My dad was around 10. There was a family of 13 that they came across Canada by train. And then my dad's youngest brother was born in Morinville. And my mom from St. Albert, they went to Morinville. My granddad took over, bought the hotel there, so they just probably went to school together and knew each other for quite a long time.
What about the Allarie boys? They would have known French, right?
But there was none of them there. The only one, The only one that was there the year I started school was Trey's, because she took grade one in Jarvie, and then I think they all did, and then went to the convent. Mm-hmm. So no, there wasn't. It was only Robert Vigneault, and well, of course Leonard was older, but.
Oh, interesting. Yeah. Well, Arthur, what is your full name, including any nicknames that you might have had?
Arthur Joseph Allarie.
Were you named after someone special?
I was named after somebody really special, my dad.
Right.
Because you were born?
On May the 5th, 1929.
On the same day as your dad.
Birthday. And where were you born?
I was born in Westlock.
In the hospital there?
In the hospital, yeah. As far as I can remember.
What do you remember about the character and personality of your mom?
Well, you know, I was only 12 or 11 when she passed away. I would have to say my memories of her were very good.
Okay, and your dad?
My dad was excellent. You know, he was excellent all through my life, you know, because of course we had him right till he passed away here not long ago.
Yeah.
So he was an easy man to get along with.
That's because you were so good.
I guess I was so good.
Such an angel.
Oh, and Pauline, what do you remember about Mr. and Mrs. Allarie?
Well, I remember lots about Mr. Allarie, because, you know, we spent a lot of time there. But I recall Mrs. Allarie because the day we moved to Jarvie, we came up by car. My mom and dad, Annette and I, and Mrs. Roberge and her three girls all in one car, and then everything else, the cattle and everything else we owned, came by train. And I remember going, we stayed at Vigneault's that night, and then they had to unload the train, the cattle, when the train got into town about 8 or 9 o'clock. And the townspeople all helped to herd the cattle because they had to go across the bridge. So it took a lot of help to get them to go over the bridge. And I remember staying at Vigneault's that night. And then a couple days later, I remember going to Allarie's house, and there was a new baby there, and it was Louis. We moved April 14th to Jarvie, and Louis was born on the 12th. So he was just a couple days old. Yeah.
What attracted your family to Jarvie? How did you end up there?
I guess my dad couldn't get any more land in Mornville. He only had a quarter, and they knew Mr. and Mrs. Allarie very well, because Mr. Allarie had worked in Mornville, and they knew his Maria, and they just went up there, or Mr. Allarie may have been in Mornville and said, you know, I have a half section of land if you want to buy. So it was Mr. Allarie that, you know, drew us up there, I guess. It was through him.
Right, and you would have known him much
longer
and better than
yes,
Grandma.
But I remember going to Allarie's and that first year playing with Therese.
Well, I had a bike.
You had a bike?
I had a bike, yeah.
Did everybody have their own bike, or?
No, there wasn't. Not many children and not many friends didn't have a bike. You know, I think we were the more fortunate ones, you know, that we had a bike, because a lot of them didn't have bikes for sure.
Yeah. We had bikes, I guess thanks to my grandma in Mornville. She always made sure we had what we needed. But Annette and I rode bikes to school in the summertime.
So how far were you from the school?
2.5 miles.
Oh, so you did need some way to get in.
Yeah, but we walked most of the time.
Oh, did you?
Oh, and then in the evening, in the winter time, Annette and I would walk to school, walk back, milk our cows, have supper, walk to town and skate for 2 hours. You ask Eddie Nelson about that. But we used to skate down at the river, yes, and for a couple of hours, and then walk home.
Yeah.
In the summertime, you'd walk down to swim in the river.
And even at night, we would walk into town just to go see the train, because, you know, summertime it was nice. It was a 20-minute walk, you know. Well, it was one in Jarvie. Yeah, there was a restaurant. We used to go there lots and have pie and coffee. Mrs. Plant used to make nice pies. And then Mrs. Vigneault took over the restaurant, and she made excellent pies. We used to have lots of pie and coffee there.
We had a radio, which a lot of people didn't have. I remember the elevator guy, Pat Newnham, he used to come down. He lived just back of us on the hill there, just back of us, and he used to come down every noon to listen to the report of
market
the
report.
Market report for the elevator. And he didn't even have a radio, and he was the elevator man.
But
so.
We-